ಉದ್ಗೀತ ಪ್ರಣವೋದ್ಗೀತ ಸರ್ವಭಾಗೀಶ್ವರೇಶ್ವರ ಸರ್ವವೇದಮಯಶ್ಚಿಂತೆ ಸರ್ವಂ ಬೋಧಯ ಬೋಧಯ. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೇದಿಕೆ ಮೇಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಗಣ್ಯರಿಗೆ, ಮುಂದೆ ಕುಂತಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರಿಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೆನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಎ ಬ್ರೀಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 64 ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್, I was immensely pleased because earlier occasions also I have spoken about this little here and there in television channels. Wonderful. This program itself is a gem of a program. We talk about the gemology, Manirajaka Ranjanam, Jnanam. We have come across the love for precious stones. Even men, women, old, young, everybody want it. It's implanted in the mind of human beings. Some people even decorate their dogs and horses with gemstones. The study of the planets is astronomy. Study of planets is astronomy. The study of the effect of the planets on the living beings, that too on human being, is astrology. The one of the angas of Veda, Jyotisha, morning Dr. Nagaraj Rao was speaking about Vidya and Kala. If astrology is a Vidya, gemology is a Kala. So it's a part of astrology, a very, very vast ocean. Many Puranas have given information on gems, especially Agni Purana has information on the formation, identification, properties and their uses in detail. The characteristics effective of dealt in details in Brihat Samhita also. Mani, mantra, aushadha, that's how the astrological practice goes. Many places we have suggested manis, mantras, aushadhas, all part of the 64 kalas. Let us see two major things, the subjective and objective. The subjective is, I always tell, respects to doctors, allopathy, regular doctors. I always say, when doctors are worried about the candle, the spiritual workers are worried about the flame. The candle may be little this way, that way, but the flame should be always correct. Formation of the gemstone. One is mineral and another is organic. We can say pearl and coral are organic. It is grown in water, sea. Other things are mineral, which comes from deep down the earth. Sun and moon are the major biodegradable agents on the earth. For example, we put a seed and put too much of water, it gets decomposed. If you don't put any water, it gets dried up. So the essence of sun and moon is always required. That shows that. Some people ask me, ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಇದೆ ಸರ್ ಗ್ರಹ, ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದನೋ ಕಿರಣ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಬಂದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತೆಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ, ನೋಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇಟ್. ಥೌಸಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈಬ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಓದ್ತೀವಿ, ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿ, ಜೆಮಾಲಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಫರಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ದಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್. ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಪರಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ cause and different effects. The gems are formed under the earth. The gems as a seed deeply embedded in the earth, and it is formed. Mineral gems, all of you know, mineral gems means diamond, ruby, emerald, yellow sapphire, cat's eye, andre manikya, muttu, avala, pacche kallu, emerald ante heltivi, matte pushyaraga, neela, gomedaka, matte cat's eye antandre vaidurya. ಈ ಮುತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ನೀರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಮುತ್ತು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿ. ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಎವ್ರಿ ವುಮನ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಸೌತ್ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ತ್, ಮಾಂಗಲ್ಯಸರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಳ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮಾಂಗಲ್ಯಸರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಳ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವಳ ಇಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫೈಯರ್. ನಾನು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ನೋವು ಇದ್ದವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅವಳ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಒಂದು ತಿಂಗಳಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಖಂಡಿತ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದಿ ರೇಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವ್ ಗುಡ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಪರ್ಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ 12 ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಮುತ್ತು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ನೋ, ಬಟ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್, ಶಂಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ನೇಕಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬ್ಯಾಂಬೂ ಶೂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೆವಿ ರೈನ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಗೋಲ್ಡನ್ ಫಿಶಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಲೌಡಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಶೆಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಶೆಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಸಿ, ಡೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಿ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಿ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನವರತ್ನಾಸ್. ಈಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟರಿ ವೈಬ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆಮ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೈಡಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದರ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಟಾಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ದೆಮ್. ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ನೀವು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಭಾಳ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಹೌ ಟು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ಜೆಮ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್. ದಿ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್. ಐ ಸೆಟ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್. ಈವನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪುರಾಣ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಸೇಸ್ ದಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಲಿವ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ತ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅನ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಶನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ತ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಸೌತ್ ಆಫ್ರಿಕಾ ಇಸ್ ರಿಚ್ ಇನ್ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್. ನಾವು ಈ ಸೇ ಸೌತ್ ಆಫ್ರಿಕನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಇನ್ ದರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಕಾರ್ಬನೇಟೆಡ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವೇ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈಡ್, ಮೈಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್ಡ್. ಟೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಮೇಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಈವನ್ ಟುಡೇ ದಿ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಓವರ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸೂರತ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್ಡ್. ದಿ ಮೋರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್ಡ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಒನ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈಮಂಡ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ 108 ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್. ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್, ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್. ದಿ ಜೆಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಸೆಸ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ ಸೀಸ್ ವಿ ಸೇ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಲರ್, ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ, ಕಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಟ್. ದಿ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ದಿ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ. ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿಸ್ ಗೇವ್ ಅಕ್ಯುರೇಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಡಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮಂಡೇನ್ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿಕಲ್, ಮಂಡೇನ್ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಡಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ರವಾಹ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವಾಗ ಚಂಡಮಾರುತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮಂಡೇನ್ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾ. ವಿಚ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಜೆಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಎನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರೋಲ್. ದೋ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಗ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೆಮ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್, ಭಾರತ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಯರ್. ದಿ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಶ್ಡ್. ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ಓದಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೀದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಚಿನ್ನ ವಜ್ರಗಳ. ಐ ಮೀನ್ ನವರತ್ನಾಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಅಂತ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಜಯನಗರ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ. ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೆಲ್ ಯು. ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಬ್ರಾಟ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಆಡಿಯೋ ವಿಜುವಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್, ಬಟ್ ಐ ಕುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಎ ಎಲಾಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು. See, this is a coral. When I put a drop of water, it will never come down. The coral will hold whichever way I turn. Whereas a nice surface, if you put a drop of water, it will fall down immediately. The property is, it is grown in sea, it can hold water. When you buy a coral or pearl, just put a drop of water and see, even if I keep it here, it will get dried up, it will not come down. That is the test usually made for coral and pearl. Other stones, there are different methods. I cannot demonstrate it now, but still it is very good to know. The mineral stones have carbon, beryllium, calcium, aluminium, hydrogen, phosphorus, manganese, potassium, opal, fire is also there. That's why you see, when we go to homeopathy, all these chemicals, you know, bio. See, our body is what you call, I always say, the astrological factors are by the effect of the planets. It's a biochemical imbalance of the body where all the five elements are put together to live a better life. The identification is over, mining is over, usage is also there. Idea, belief, race, manifestation and its effect are all felt by the areas of, in the areas of health, wealth, prosperity. Olden days it was omelets and talisman. Taita kattukottare athwa eno ond kalla kottare antella helta idru. Even today I'll tell you, Bangalore is prone for all nasal problems, and doctors say allergic rhinitis. People will cough, people will cold, in the body eosinophilus will go down. I always say, when there is a planetary influence on a person, if it is good, it will definitely make him more good in his physical and mental areas. If it is not good, it first affects your endorphin levels. It brings down your happy situational areas. the endorphins, serotonins and other brain chemicals are reduced. When we have suggested some stones for that, people have said, yes sir, I am quite fine, I get better sleep, things are really improving, I have better digestion, all these things they say. So astrologically there is a corresponding effect and result on human being. Why living beings also, as I said already, Ayurveda also uses Avala Bhasma, Muttu Bhasma, all Bhasmas are used in Ayurveda. So every human being has got a bioplasmic energy. Krenlian photography is one famous photography where it has been identified. You can photograph yourself. Bangalore also there is a studio. You go, we call Prabhavali in Telthivala. Manishanike 1.5 inch Prabhavali irutte, mai mele. A Prabhavalike dent varutte. Idana Prabhavali manishanike enta adik munche, Luther Burbank anta is a very great articles list he found out. He used to go and talk to trees. When the tree was not well, he found out that the aura of the tree is depleted. And there are many several areas where the polygraph, what we call polygraph, anta on machine ide. Police ella use martare. Lie detector test anta heltare. Lie detector test anta heltare. A lie detector test is not taken as a witness in the court, but it can extract more truth from a person. So a polygraph test madadaga, the bioplasmic energy of the person has been seen, what it is increased or decreased. When he was asked to own some gems, it was found some of the areas of his depletion has got recovered and he becomes all right. Unfortunately, not much funds or not much support is given in India to do all these things. Westerners are really doing it well. I would like to just tell you now, there is more demand for Navaratnas because supply is less. There is precious and semi-precious stones. As it was said, how many herbs are there? We have almost 240 precious stones. Among that, 9 is the gemstone. The important gemstone 9. And ruby, which can increase the body heat, it can give courage. I would say any gemstone can act in physical, mental, biological, psychological, social and intellectual areas. Ruby can make a person courageous, popular. Indigestion is called strength, body, mind. Pearl can give eyesight, pregnancy. There was a girl who had gynecological problems. Diamond acts against uterus. Pearl supports uterus. Why we say no? The cycle of the mother, the cycle of a lady is 28 days. The cycle of the moon is also 28 days. When a lady is broken that stage and given a motherhood, she becomes conceived. Science has gone to the extent, if a person stands and his DNA is rolled into a roll of thread, and if he holds it, and the other end will go to up to sun. That's why we call Surya as the Pitrukaraka, Chandra as the Matrukaraka. Every planet has got a corresponding areas of operation. And coral, acidity, stomachache, gynecological problems, spirit problems. Somebody says, sir, namga adeno agogide, ideno agogide. All psychosomatic disorders can also be cured by coral. That is why during marriage, all the women are given. For her beauty, for her intelligence not to lose, she's been a coral in her Mangalya Sutra. Yellow sapphire, cold, cough, piles, knowledge, wisdom, happiness. Diamond, vigor, popularity, complexion, eye spot. That's why diamonds are given during marriage. Somebody whose Shukra is not good in horoscope, if she wears diamonds, she'll definitely get gynecological problems, hormonal imbalances. I have asked a lady to remove diamond. She said her problem will come all right. I asked a person to wear diamond, she said, I am all right. So it suits with different attitude and different person. Blue sapphire says, sir, Indra nila, nila akkolle badadun telbidare. Sir, adu potu na enak ennovo pai pochi sir, adalla illa, nothing like that. If blue diamond goes with somebody, it will go with strength, winning over enemies, service, salvation, popularity. Gomedaka, it's a white common, very, very less prized stone, which can definitely do a wonder in each one's life. Intelligence, depression, elation, psychosomatic disorders, dental problem, joints. I always tell people, when Rahu is good for a person, you will be a dental doctor. When Rahu is not good for a person, you will be a patient. Like that, the same line of action. Yes, sir, I will definitely make it within that 5 minutes, sir. So the scale of 10, 0 to 1, 0 to 10, 1 is a doctor. If Rahu is good, 1 is a jailer. Rahu is not bad, 1 is a culprit. Like that, the same line goes up. As I said, the wearing of stones can definitely improve the aura of a person, corrects the dent in the aura. It is linked between physical self and cosmic power. Crystal, many people would have seen crystal. ಸ್ಫಟಿಕಮ್ ಮಣಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸಚ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿ ಬಿ ಪಿ. ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಫೈರ್, ಎರ್ತ್, ಏರ್, ವಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಥರ್. ಒಂದು ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೂ ಕೂಡ ನಮಗೆ ಐದು ಬೇಕು, ಪಾತ್ರೆ ಬೇಕು, ಮಣ್ಣಿಂದು ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರು, ನೀರು ಹಾಕಬೇಕು, ಬೆಂಕಿ ಇಡಬೇಕು, ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು, ಜಾಗ ಬಿಡಬೇಕು. ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ತಿನ್ನಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ನಮಗೆ. ಆದರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ನ ಬ್ಲೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್, ಐ ಸೆಡ್, ಬೈ ವಾಟರ್, ಮಡ್, ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್, ಗೋಮೂತ್ರ, ಮಿಲ್ಕ್, ಹನಿ, ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಓ ವಿಭೂತಿ. ವಿಭೂತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೂಡ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಿ ಆರ್ಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಜೆಮ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಂಗರ್ ಸೆಲೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ವೈಬ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ರಿಪ್ಲಿಕಾ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟರಿ ಪವರ್. ಮೆನಿ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಗಜನಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಬಂದ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೊಡ್ಕೊಂಡೋದ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಇವಾಗ ತಿರುವನಂತಪುರಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜ್ಯುವೆಲರೀಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಗೇನ್ ಮೇಲ್ಕೋಟೆ ವೈರಮುಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವಿಶೇಷ, ವಿ ನೋ ಹೌ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಹೌ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್. ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಡೀಪ್ಲಿ ಎಂಬೆಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಭಾರತ ಧರ್ಮ ಕರ್ಮಭೂಮಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡೂ ಗುಡ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಿ ಗುಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ಗುಡ್, ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಅಡ್ವೈಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಜಮಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೇಕ್. ಐ ಡನ್ ಮೈ ಜಮಾಲಜಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಚೆನ್ನೈ ಕಿಂಡಿ, 40-45 ಡೇಸ್, ಡೇ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೈಟ್. ಫೈನಲಿ ದೇ ಪುಟ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಪಿಕ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇ ಟೆಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್, ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಬಯಾಲಜಿ, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ಅಸ್ ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಕಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಪರಿಟಿ, ಪ್ಲೆಜರ್, ಪೀಸ್, ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಹೆಲ್ತ್, ವೆಲ್ತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿನೆಸ್, ಟ್ರಬಲ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಲೈಫ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ಲಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಬಿಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಜೆಮಾಲಜಿ. ಒನ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದಿ 64 ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಭಾರತ್, ಜೆಮಾಲಜಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಜೆಮ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದೆಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೌಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಎ ಜೆಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಎಸ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಅವೇ. ಲೈಕ್ ಅವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಸೆಡ್, ದೇ ಸೇ ದಿ ಜ್ಯಾಕ್ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ 12 years ಓಲ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಯಾಯ, ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಯಾಯ, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಮಿಂಗ್. ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 12 years ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಕೌಂಟ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ. ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮಂಡಲ, 48 days, 48 ನಾಳ ಸುತ್ತಪ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಪೋಯ್ಡೋನು. ವಾವ್, ದೇ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 27 stars, 12 signs ಅಂಡ್ 9 planets. ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ 3. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಎ ಮಂಡಲ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಯು ಗುಡ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್. ನೌ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ತು, ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ 3 subjects ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಮೀ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಸ್ತು, ಅಂಗವಿದ್ಯಾ, ನಿಮಿತ್ತಂ, ಶಕುನಂ. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ಸರ್ವೇ ಭವಂತು ಸುಖಿನಃ, ಯೋಗಕ್ಷೇಮಂ ಮಹಾಮ್ಯಂ, ಆರ್ ದಿ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದ, ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್. ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಈಸ್, ಆಸ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಶೋಭಾ ಕಂಜಿಲಾಜೆ ವಾಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್, ವಸುದೇವ ಕುಟುಂಬಕಂ. ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಈವನ್ ಟುಡೇ. ಗಾಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಟೆಕ್ಟ್. ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟ್, ಇನ್ನೋವೇಟಿವ್, ಇಂಟ್ರಿಕೇಟ್, ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್, ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್, ರಿವೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನ್ರಿವೀಲಿಂಗ್. ಅನಿಮಾ, ಲಗಿಮಾ, ಮಹಿಮಾ, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ನೋ. ಸೇಜಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ವೆಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ತ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದೇರ್ ವಿಸ್ಡಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್. ವಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೇಚರ್. ವಿ ಸೇ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ಮೇಷ ಲಗ್ನಂ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಪಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಶೀಪ್, ಆಡು ಮುಟ್ಟದ ಸೊಪ್ಪಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಒಂಥರ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಓಡಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸಿಂಹದಲ್ಲಿ ಗಂಡು ಸಿಂಹ ಸೋಮಾರಿ, ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಸಿಂಹ ಭಾಳ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವ್. ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಸಿಂಹನೇ ಬೇಟೆ ಆಡೋದು, ಇಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಂಟ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಸೇ ಇನ್ ಮೆನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಮೆನ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಿಂಹ ಲಗ್ನ, ಲೇಡಿ ಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಬಟ್ 11th ಅವರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ವುಮನ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿಂಹ ಲಗ್ನ, ದೇ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಡೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವೇ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿ ಡ್ರಾಸ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಸೇ ಎಕಾಲಜಿ, ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫ್ರೀ, ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ, ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಂಚುರಿ. ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್. ಟು ಲಿವ್ ಇನ್ ವಿತ್ ಅವರ್ ಮನಿ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ನೇಚರ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೇಜಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆನ್ಸೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ದಿ ಮೇಜರ್ ಫೈವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಆಸ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಯು, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್, ಸಸ್ಟೆನೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್. ಫೈರ್, ಏರ್, ಏರ್, ಈಥರ್, ವಾಟರ್. ಅರ್ತ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್, ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್, ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್, ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ನಾಟ್, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಯು ಸೇ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಫೋನ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಯು, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಯರ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆರ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಗುಹಾಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಸೇಜಸ್ did penetration. Even you go to underground, you say go to the cell, to your apartment, the waves will not come. So that's how things have been planned by our people to protect us from ultraviolet rays, infrared rays. We say Margari Masam. See, we say Margasira, morning bhajans. The ozone layer is more. When you go open chest also in the climate, nothing will happen. Extra ozone layer is, now we drink ozonated water. There is, in a vastu house, if you keep water, it will get ozonated. That is how they have planned everything. I would say vastu's meaning is dwelling place, prayer hall, temple, education, hospitals, walking. All related. Even how to sleep, how to take bath, how to eat, how to go around your house, how to make garden, everything comes in vastu. In ancient India, every manifestation has its religious sanctity and its meaning. Ashtadikpalakas are given very important position. We have iruvadan ittukondu ilde idan udukode vastu. And all materials, what we say, materials transform us to be matured living. Somebody was telling, God made man, tailor made him gentleman and tailor. Atara, so many times the materials only make us. Vastu leads to health, wealth and happiness. Matsya Purana also elaborately says about Vastu. Like Markandeya Purana says about the fetal movements and fetus, Matsya Purana says about Vastu. We have 8 directions, all of you know that. Atradik Devatas are there. By making an Vastu house, it is most common sense. Somebody says southwest should be elevated. It is the elevation. The sun goes on its own axis. The earth goes on its own axis. Example, I'll show you. 30 kilometers of earth has gone. That is the speed in which earth is moving. They say nowadays vastu sleep to their head. Yakendre talai bara south alli idre avale. No. When you go, last rites only done in south. Please don't believe. You should always sleep east or west. The electroencephalograph of the brain. I have modeled some nursing homes. Doctors say, really, sir, it is helping. Patients are good. They are healthy. When you sleep east-west, it is natural. Even the sleep what you get, it is enough for you. South, somebody may say, because south was left granary, Kanijai Tidro. Ali WHO says, anything stored under 25 degree, it will retain its potency. So you go to your house in southwest corner, it will be always little dark. So it's a temperature wise also, it will be less. So that's why they are kept. Northeast, don't keep stove, they say. Southeast, you keep the stove. Olden days, all chullas were there. Your left movement is easy. Your right movement is difficult. The centrifugal force is always towards the left. All scientific factors have been taken into consideration while building and wash the house. Now, what I would like to say here is the mere attention to a place, foundation, structures, elevation, beauty, all these things people nowadays see. But even a mud house can have its own vastu properties and still do good to the people there. Planned as per vastu definitely gives you very good results. We always say, your house is built of hands, your home is built of hearts. Somebody who has vastu, I would always say 10 to 15% it helps. It is like a vessel. Olle patre. If it's a vessel means it's a vehicle also. Car bala BMW chennagidanta alle samsara madalanu. We just get down and go to our work also. Like that, it's a good vessel. I would always say vastu is like a good inflated tire to a good vehicle. It is not the engine, it is not the gearbox, but it is an inflated tire, which is also very important. Vastu is most common sense, as I said, sleeping, bathing, eating. We say always people who sleep in a vastu house, east-west, it is healthy. Somebody who sits facing west or east, health will improve. For financial gains, you face western sleep. Always stand east and take bath. Vastu Purana also says, please don't take bath without a loincloth or a cloth around you. In a vastu house, this also plays an important factor. Don't put your cloths on the doors. Lot of things. If you give me whole day, I say, Nagarajasav said, old day I will tell about vastu, but still the time constraint is there. Like cities, temples still survive. Nagareshu Kanchi, we say. All those Pataliputra, all those big cities are still there, but some cities have gone. I'd like to tell here one thing. You can all imagine why Bangalore has become so popular. Sir was telling, he was from Ujjain. Morning governor was telling. Ujjain is Madhya Pradesh. Our Indian standard time is set for Ujjain. We have local time also for astrological calculations. 19 minutes difference is there for Indian standard time and local time. When Ujjain is the Saraswati Kshetra where Kalidasa got his blessings, the straight line is Varanasi. From there, Ujjain straight line. Varanasi where Parvati, Annapurne, Sadapurne, Shankarapurana will be, all your strength is given by Parvati. It is a triangle directly to Bangalore. It is 300 kilometers east side sea and 600 kilometers down. This is the Lakshmi Kshetra. It is called Kanakapuri. That's why it is becoming more popular. It is not an equilateral triangle. In one of my books, my father has wrote this. When he came to Bangalore, long time, 70 years back, he said this city will develop into a big city. He has written in his book. He has given this explanation. One side Saraswati, Lakshmi, Parvati. Come on, tell me. All three, 33% is the Rajayogi. If you have money, don't have health. If you have health, don't have knowledge. Everything is lost. By living in your vastu house, I presume, I assure that definitely it will give you all the three in a phased manner. I'll go to, see, Vastu is a very big subject, but still they have given me Angavidya also. The different directions speak about different things. Angavidya, Chamudrika, Lakshana also we say sometimes. Three ways to test anything on the earth, three ways to. We say Pratyaksham, Anumanam, Agamam. These are all the three things we have to test. Visible things, suspect things, or what Veda says. We have to go that way. Varahamihira in Bhrut Samhita as a chapter on Angavidya. All living beings have instincts, you know. It is found out that man has got an extra instinct, 14th instinct. All animals, many animals, orangutan has got 12 instincts. Instincts means anger, sleep, natural things. 14th is laugh. Nobody else can laugh, only man can laugh. Because he can logically analyze what it is in him. So, Angavidya also says, if a man coming laughing, if a man laughs for purpose, if a man laughs for just to cheat somebody, all these things are in Angavidya. As I said, Angavidya is the significant traditional knowledge of Bharat. The movement of the body, limbs, neck and legs, speech, gesture, what not, everything comes into this. A person's body, mind, soul are the expression of his living. ನೋಡಿ ಯಾವಾಗಾದ್ರೂ ಯಾರು ಹಿಂಗೆ ತಲೆ ಕರೆದ್ರೆ ಏನೋ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂತ, ಹಿಂದೆ ಕರೆದ್ರೆ ಅಯ್ಯೋ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಸಾರಿ ಸಮಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ಅಂತ. ಅಂದರೆ ದಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ನು ನಾವು ವಾಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಕೂಡ ಕೈ ಬೀಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತು ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಆಡೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಿವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್, ದಟ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಡ್ರೈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ನೋ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ವಾಕ್, ಇಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಯುಸ್ಟಾಚಿಯನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಂತಿದೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ನೀವು ಕಿವಿ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ 4 ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ಇಟ್ಟು ನೋಡಿ, 5 ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ನೀವು ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗಿರ್ತೀರ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೈಂಟೈನ್ ಬೈ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಅಂಗವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಸೇ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಶ್ನ, ದಿ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸಮ್ ಟೈಪ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್, ನಮಗೆ ಜಾತಕ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇದಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಹೇಳಿ ಸರ್ ಅಂದರೆ, ಅವ್ನು ಎದೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೈ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಏನೋ ಯಾರೋ ಬೇರೆ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅಣ್ಣಂದಿರು, ಸಂಬಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ಅವೇ. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್, ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಬರ್ತ್, ಮ್ಯಾರೇಜ್, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಓಲ್ಡನ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಬಫಲೋಸ್, ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೋಲನ್, ದೇಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್. ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ಬಂದು ಆಡೀಸು, ಬೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಳೆದೋಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಕೂಡ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕೂಡ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಲಾಸ್ಟು ಚಿನ್ನ ಬೆಳ್ಳಿ ಕಳೆದೋಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಕಾರ್ತವೀರಾರ್ಜುನ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಮ್ದು ಏನಾದ್ರು ಮನೇಲಿ ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿ ಅಥವಾ ಹೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಮಧೇನು ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಇಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್, ವೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಹೌ ಈ ಸಿಟ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಹೌ ಈ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್, ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ಅಷ್ಟಾಕ್ರ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೀನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಡಿಕ್ಷನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟೈಸ್. ಸಂಬಡಿ ಟಚಸ್ ದಿ ಗೇಟ್, ಸಂಬಡಿ ಟಚಸ್ ದಿ ಫೋರ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂಬಸಿ, ಟಚಸ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಸೈಡ್, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಏನು ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್, ಸಬ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್, ಸೂಪರ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೇರ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗ್ರಾಸ್ಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ದಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಅಂಗವಿದ್ಯ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕೆನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಸೆಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್. ಐ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಇ ವಾಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್, ಇ ವಾಸ್ ಯಾನಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಸೆಟ್ ಬೆಡ್ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನೋಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಸಿಕ್ತು ಅವ್ರು, ಯಾರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು ಚೈನ್, ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಇಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಒಂದು ತಿಂಗಳಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಬೆಡ್ ಎತ್ತು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕವರ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೋಗಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲೂ ಐ ಗಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೆಮ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಯಾನಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಥಾಟ್ ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹವ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್. So the time has come. I may take 1 or 2 minutes more. Woman, this is a part of astrological prediction. It nature helps to feel future past events by observing good bad things around us. Many texts, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Rama also says woman is telling. Mahabharata also it comes, Draupadi says what will happen in future. So the woman Shakuna nammalli samanyavagi bekkadda hobutre ellaru inde bare aadikar kuda nintogutte. Sometime you see. See, ದಿನನಿತ್ಯ ಮಾಡೋ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಿಗೆ ಓಮನ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರು ವಿಶೇಷವಾದಂಥ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಿಗೆ, ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೋ ಕೆಲಸ ನಿಮಿತ್ತವಾಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಆ ಕೆಲಸ ನೀವು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಈವನ್ ಶೇಕ್ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ, ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ವಿದೇಶಿಯರು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಮುಲ್ಲರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮವ್ರು ನಂಬಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಶೇಕ್ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಕೂಡ ತನ್ನ ಜೂಲಿಯಸ್ ಸೀಸರ್ ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ದೇರ್ ಶ್ಯಾಡೋ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಬರೋದನ್ನು ಮೊದಲೇ ಸೂತ್ಸೇಯರ್ ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ಬ ಬರ್ತಾನಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ನು ಬಂದು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಮೇ ಫೀಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ಸ್ಟಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದಿ we have to accept crows, snakes, birds behave differently during tsunamis. Tsunami bandaga pakshi pranigalella science oppolutivaga how they receive the information signal anta. Adrinda cat crossing irli dog crossing irli, it may tell you that world sometime back and go. People priest yaro heltare sumangali edaragade bandre cinema avaralla idan kedisibitru yaro sumangali adda bandange avaru tayar maadi kalsi madvege innu sambandha kottanga adella let should happen naturally. A man should know what happens naturally, what is instigated, what is done purposely, all these things. That's why deep study in this will definitely give you. Once I'll tell you, I said lot of things we get from this. Nimittam, I'll tell Nimittam. Nimittam, Sakunam is different, Nimittam is different. I was studying 4th standard, I was bayarting. Then only we got into the English, till that time our vernacular language. Carnivorous, herbivorous, carnivorous, herbivorous. My father was asking, what he was not good in English, but he was good in Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu and all. I said, they say something eating grass and plants, it is herb carnivorous. No, my brother said, no, it is not like that. Then my father said, romba easy da, that which sucks water, all are herbivorous, that licks water, all are carnivorous. you think the old day, that which licks water, all carnivorous, that sucks water, are herbivorous. That's why we get lot of things from Nimittam also. The actions caused by animal, plants, everything. For this Nimisham, even twitching. Sir, adagannu odkota ide sir, yena agutto anta phone martaru ratri 11 varel. I cannot take it seriously. I have to pacify them and tell, okay, nothing will happen. Go to the swalpa upu neeral mukha talbut malakkoli. Andre gandasrige ardhanarishwara tattva ettkondu lakshmi narayana tattva ettkondu adagannu en makkalu golledu balagannu gand makkalu golledu. Lot of angavidyas whole day madana ondissa bekaradanna. ಫೈನಲಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಈ ನಿಮಿತ್ತಮ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಫೈನಲಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಹೇಳಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮುಗಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಎರಡು ಶಿಷ್ಯಂದರು ಜ್ಯೋತಿಷ ಕಲಿತರು ಗುರುಗಳ ಹತ್ರ. ಓ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿಗೆ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಇದನ್ನು ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಒಂದು ಎಂಥೂಸಿಯಾಸಮ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ದೆನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಯ್ಯ ಯಾರೋ ಬಂದರು ಅಂತ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು. ಇಬ್ಬರು ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೋತಾರೆ ಹಳೆ ವಿಲೇಜು ಬೆಟ್ಟದ ಕೆಳಗೆ, ಗುರುಗಳು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಹೋಗಿಪ್ಪ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಗೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಬಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಡೇ ವೆರಿ ಹಾಟ್. They are passing through a hamlet, small village. They want water. Nobody is there. One says, look for water. Other says, look for water. One fellow says, the lady drawing water from the well. He says, there is water. Amma, he calls. That lady puts the pot inside. Some new voice, no? She puts it inside. Then they go to her and say, please, we want water. Please, please come. You look low, nice. Come home. She gives water, jaggery, everything. She asks, who are you? How you are going here? They say, we learnt astrology. Nimittam, Shakunam, everything from our Guruji, we are going to practice. She says, there is one question. One of my sister is there. Please answer one question. We get all clients from train journey, aeroplane journey, every journey we get. You should not feel bad. If it is a time to tell, you can tell. Otherwise, you can tell, I'll tell something sometime later. Then coming to the story, she says, my sister is there. Her husband has ran away long time. Just tell, can she wear kumkum? Will he come back or not? Then both shishya say, there is no astrology, nothing. Nimittam, Shakunam, we have to see. Come on, you tell. One fellow says, he will not come. The other fellow from the same guru says, he will come. After 4 or 5 hours, it was very hot evening. She says, I'll send you by bullock cart, wait. One fellow with beard and all comes. He happens to be her husband. Now the question is, whether Nimittam, Shakunam will work. One says yes, one says no. The person who said no, yengappa nin baralla ante helidandre, ನಾನು ಆ ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಅವಳು ನೀರು ಎಳಿತಾ ಇದ್ಲು, ಭ್ರಷ್ಟೋದಯ ಅಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲಜಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿರಸೋದಯ ಭ್ರಷ್ಟೋದಯ ಅಂತಿದೆ. ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಅರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್, ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಡ್ರಾ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್. ವೆನ್ ಐ ಕಾಲ್ ಶಿ ಲೆಫ್ ದಿ ರೋಪ್. ಮಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್, ರೋಪ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, தட்ஸ் ஆல் தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் யூ வில் நாட் கம். ಮಣ್ಣು ಸೇರ್ಬಿಡ್ತು, ದಾರ ಕಿತ್ತೋಯ್ತು, ಇನ್ನೆಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ? ನೀನು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದೆ, ಬಂದ್ರಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಅದೇ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದೆಪ್ಪ, ನಾನು ಈ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ, ಆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಈ ಕಡೆ ತಿರುಗಿದ್ಲು, ಅಷ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಸಿರಸೋದಿಯಾನ ನೋಡಿದೆ ಅವಳ್ದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಆಚೆ ನನಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತು. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಬಾವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಡಕೆ ಒಡೆದಾದಾಗ ಮಣ್ಣು ಮಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಸೇರ್ಕೋತು, ನೀರು ನೀರಿಗೆ ಸೇರ್ಕೋತು ಬರ್ತಾನಂತೇಳಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಆ ಥರ ನಿಮಿತ್ತಂ ಸಕುನಂ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೋಟ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ನಾನು ಹಿಂಗೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ, ಇವನಿಗೆ ರಾಹು ದೇಶ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಇವನಿಗೆ ಗುರು ದೇಶ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಎನ್ಹ್ಯಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಅವರ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್. ವಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕಾಮೆಂಟ್, ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೈ ವೈಫ್, ಓಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ದಿ ಕೇಸ್, ದಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ದಿ ಕೇಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಲೈಫ್ ಇಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್. ಏಳೇಳು ಜನ್ಮ ಬೇಡ ಅಂತಾರೆ, ಏಳೇಳು ಜನ್ಮ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತಗಳ ಕಳೆಗಳನ್ನು ಕಳೆಯುವಂಥ ಜನ್ಮ ಕೊಡಲಿ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.
ಹಾಂ, ಈಗ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಬಹುಶಃ ನಾವು ಯಾರು ಇದನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಲೆ ಅಂತ ಓದಿಲ್ಲ. ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಆವ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಓದಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಆರ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನೋ ನೋ ನೋ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅಥವಾ ಡ್ಯೂ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳೋರೇ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಕಂಡು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಎಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ 64 ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರೀಸ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಆನಂದ್ ವಿಶ್ವನಾಥನ್ ಜಿ. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಅಸ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ಆನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಸರ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್. ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಏನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್, CAHC, ಜೈನ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಮೇಟ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ PhD ಆನ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಜೈನ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಮೇಟ್. ರಿಸರ್ಚಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟರಿ ಪಾತ್ಸ್, ಪಿರಿಯಾಡಿಸಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತಿಕ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಆನಂದ್ ವಿಶ್ವನಾಥನ್ ಜಿ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಆನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಟ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಮುತ್ತಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಮುತ್ತಿನ ಆಭರಣದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ದಂಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳೆ ಹೊಡೆದು ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಚಪ್ಪಾಳೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ.
ನಮಸ್ಸರ್ವೇಭ್ಯಃ. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಅವೇ. ಗಣಿತಂ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್. ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಲಾ. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಕಲಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್? ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಅ list of names. This is not an exhaustive list, but you can see there is a Samavaya Sutram. It is a Prakritam text. That is why there is Ganiyam listed as second in the list. It list meaning list of kalas. There are 87 kalas listed in this. And there is a Lalita Vistaraha, which someone mentioned in the morning. There Ganana is also listed. Sankhya is also separately listed. And 86 kalas are mentioned. Similarly, Kama Sutram, Kadambari, there are many, many texts here which lists. In fact, I have not listed them exhaustively. There is one Katha Ratna Karaha where 72 kalas are listed. 72 number seems to be there in many Jain texts, for example. 64 is obviously popular, we know. Next one, please. Before going to this, ಗಣಿತಂ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಸಾಂಖ್ಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್. ಸಾಂಖ್ಯಕಾರಿಕ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ನೋ. ವಿ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ದರ್ಶನ ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ ಪುರುಷ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 24 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 1 ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ತತ್ವಾಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಸಾಂಖ್ಯಂ ವಾಸ್ ಜನರಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫಿನಾಮಿನನ್ ಆರ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ಸ್. It starts right from the Vedas, in the sense there are many, many unique numbers, 3, 7, 9, these we know about. But I don't know how many of you have heard the number 3,339. This is a special number in Rigveda itself, mentioned twice, in the context of cycle of Chandra, Chandra Grahana Chakram. Not just observing, but we also tend to quantify it, classify, categorize, and also quantify phenomenon if it is possible. So that is where science starts, and obviously Ganitam is part of every science, but there is a Kala aspect to it. As we get into it further, I'll let you know. So Vedas have lot of important numbers. It's a vast subject by itself, so I won't go into it. Just for the sake of kindling some interest, I have put one extract from Mahabharatam. So Ashtavakra Rishi, you might have heard his name. He has a debate with Bandi. There is a background to it. But he comes to Janaka Sabha. He has a debate with him. I didn't know for a long time what it was on. I thought it was some Shastra Artha, some Darshana related debate. But when I went into Mahabharata, I came to know it is on numbers. So for example, Ashtavakra, Samitau Garjamano, Jatakrodho, Vandimaha Rajan, Ukte Vakye Chotaram Me Bravihi, Vakyasya Chapyuttaram Te Bravimi. You tell something, I will tell the next one. Then you follow that up with the next one. What is next? Importance of numbers, essentially. So for example, Bandi starts here. Eka evagnir bahudha samidhyate eka suryah sarvamidam prabhasate. So he is relating things with respect to one. That's it. This, why I am giving this example is, it is not just computation, but knowing the importance of numbers and significance of numbers is also part of it. So the debate itself is centered on it. And so he lists whatever is one. There is one Surya, there is only one Agni, but it is separated by several qualities and so on. Ashtavakra starts, Dvav Indra Agni, then Dvav Devarishi Naradav Parvatasya. What is all two? He lists. Then Bandi lists three and so on. Can you go to the next slide, please? This keeps going on like that. Then Bandi, Ekadashaikadashinaha Pashunam Eka, sorry, there is a mistake, Ekadashaivatra Bhavanti Yupaha. So he lists 11. Then Ashtavakra follows up with 12. Samvatsaram Dvadasha Masa. So there are 12 months in a year. And then there are Chandas that has 12 Aksharas and so on. Then he has to talk about 13. So he says, Trayodashi Tithirukta Mahogra Trayodasha Dvipavati Mahicha. This is interesting. There is some information there. I will not go into it. And then he is unable to complete it. He doesn't know enough to complete second half of the verse, about 13. Then Ashtavakra pitches in, and then Trayodashahani Sasarakeshi Trayodashadin Yatichandamsi Chahuhu. There is a Chandas that has 13 Aksharas, and there is a Keshi. It might have something to do with comets, probably. Not very sure. So he completes more items on 13, and then he wins. Later on, the story continues. But so much importance was given to recognition of important numbers and phenomenon associated with those numbers. Next, please. Similarly, there is one more example that I wanted to show, which is again quite famous. It is from Lalita Vistara. It's a Buddhist text. There, Shuddhodana is there. Shuddhodana is the father of Siddhartha Gautama. He says there is a Mahamatra, Ganaka Mahamatrena Arjunena Sardham Putra Sankhyajnana Kaushalya Gananagatim Anupraveshtum Shakyasi. Shakyasi may be Apanini Prayoga, but Shaknoshi, whatever. So he asks, okay, there is a mathematician here, he knows so many numbers. Can you enter into a, it's not a debate, but can you just sit with him and have a discussion? Then he says, okay, let him start. Then he starts with a number. This, I think the starting itself is 10 to the power 7 or something, because below that is meaningless. Everyone knows. So he starts, and then later on, he Koti Shatottara Ganana Gatir Anupraveshtavya Bodhisattva Aha Shatam Koti Nam Ayutam Namochyate. So he keeps on going to a higher unit, 10 multiplied by 10, and keeps on naming further and further. Can you go to the next one, please? I think he goes up to at least 10 to the power 53, if not more, probably more than that. So each one of these is named, and not just the name. Later on, he goes on to say things like, you can look at the second line, dvajagravati nama ganana, dvajagravati nama ganana yasyam gananayam ganganadi valika sama valuka ar valika sama lakshanikshepa kriyaya parikshayam gacheyuhu. So tries to name some quantities or entities that might be described by these numbers. For example, number of sand particles in the Ganga, number of sand particles in 10 Gangas, like that. So there is a lot of it here, but finally, Bodhisattva, that is Buddha, wins the contest because the other person is unable to name more numbers. Next one, please. So, knowledge of numbers, big numbers, and what they probably may signify is one aspect. Today, we can relate to it to an extent in the sense of astronomical numbers, and there are constants also. This is an older one, historically I am presenting, but there are many constants and large numbers that have come into picture in physics, etc. Those can be included in this extension of this Vidya or Kala. Then the real computation part of it comes into picture, which is Parikarmashtakam. So there are 8 operations, all of us know this, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So Sankalanam, Vyavakalanam, Gananam, Bhagaharaha, Vargaha, Vargamulam, Ghanaha, Ghanamulam. Cube root. Here I have just given the cube root algorithm as in Leelavati. This cube root is there right from Aryabhatiyam onwards. Most of the books have this. I won't go into the details, but I'll quickly just tell this. This is a perfect cube. This can be done for imperfect cubes also too in some other way. But here there is a perfect cube. You divide it into first one, then the second two are of other category, then one more, then two, then one. Then you do, so we know this 3a square, b, 3ab square, all these parts come into a cube. So there is a list of a series of paripati. Paripati is our word for algorithm. Algorithm is after Al-Khwarizmi as we know, but we are the inventors of this thing. This is called paripati in our tradition. So he gives this and there is a... And this cube root obviously involves most of the other operations. That is why I listed it here. And this is supposed to be the most important set. And anything is usually based out of this, these fundamental 8 operations. And whether you can get shortcuts for these, that is another issue. There were shortcuts, but I won't go into what is nowadays known as Vedic mathematics because I am dealing with the parampara as of now. Okay, next please. Okay, so once there are details of how to do multiplication, division, etc., there are various paripatis described in various books. And there are problems posed also. For example, Kala. Why do we call it Kala? This is one example where we can relate to how they try to look at numbers. In the morning session, for example, Avadhani Chitrakavi Shankar told that as a Chitrakavi, you should look at words or padams for their own end, not as some means of communication only. Similarly here, numbers are their own end, in so to speak. For example, there is a set of problems. This is from Ganitasara Sangraha of Mahaviracharya. Won't read this problem, but you can see there are 2 numbers given in either, usually in Bhuta Sankhya, or Katapayadi Sankhya, which are modes of representing numbers in Sanskritam. Kathitam Narapala Kantika Bharanam. So there are 2 numbers given as a problem. You multiply them and you will get a Kantha Bharanam. What is a Kantha Bharanam? Why is he saying so? There are 2 numbers in the 12th shloka. I have just listed it out. 1428, 7143. Asked to multiply by 7. Once you do it, you get this. So this they have visualized as a necklace. 10001, maybe this you can think of as a pendant, middle, then 0001. Similarly, there is another 14th shloka which gives, see, for example, 14th, Giri Guna Divi, Giri Guna Divi, Giri Guna Nikaram, Tathaiva Guna Gunitam. Guna is 3, Trigunaha, so the word Guna represents 3. So multiply these 2 and you will get this, all ones. So discovering such numbers, posing such questions and seeing it as a pattern, these involve some amount of entertainment also, apart from skill. Next one, please. So it is not visible, I think. Yeah. Okay. Again, there is one more problem where you multiply and get 1, 8 zeros and 1. I try to visualize it. 1 and 1, there are 8 pearls in between. That is how they visualized. Okay, next one. With the basic operations, trirashikam. Trirashikam, everyone knows, if this costs this much, how much will something else cost? That kind of problem. If some person moves such and such length in some time, how long will it take for him to move 10 kilometers? Something. So problems like this are quite common. This is not just a daily problem. Most of the astronomy texts employ techniques that were used in all of these Ganita texts. So Ganita and Jyotisham developed very closely in India. This Trairashikam is used in various contexts, including Ahargana, number of day calculations, etc. But they recognize that there is direct variation and inverse proportions also. There are cases where inverse proportions need to be. So randomly they will pose questions. And if, for example, you use a scale which is half a feet in length and measure, and you get a particular unit of measurement, I mean 10 units or 10. Then if you increase the scale, for example, you have 1 feet scale, then how many units will the same thing measure to? Obviously it will reduce. So those, and then if there is age difference, if age increases for an animal which is bought and sold, then obviously the price will reduce because it is no more in its prime time, prime period. So there are cases like that where Vyasta Trairashikam is used. These are both practical as well as suddenly if you pose as a challenge, it will be more like a puzzle solving also. Next one. Similarly, there are other two variable is usual, puzzles or questions, which are both useful in context of Jyotisham, but even as a general way of keeping your calculations sharp. If you have to do some of this mentally, it becomes a little difficult. So there was a Ganaka mathematician called Chitrabhanu in Kerala. The Kerala tradition is quite famous, starting from Sangamagrama Madhava, Damodara, Parameshwara, Neelakanta Somayaji, Jeshtadeva, etc. There was a Ganaka called Chitrabhanu who talked about 21 different problems. All of this will be like this. X plus y is given, x minus y is given, find x and y. Starting from such simple ones, it gets a little complicated. Can you go to the next one, please? See, the last few I have listed, 16 to 21, the last some x square minus y square is known, x cube minus y cube is known. Similarly, x cube plus y cube is known, x cube minus, so all these combinations, and you will have to ultimately find out x and y, that's it. And some of them are a little bit involved. You have to know some identities. Then finally, sometimes you will have to apply procedures which apply to previous ones, previous problems also, after some steps here. Next one, please. So I'll try to conclude fast. Bhadraganitam is magic squares. Magic square is pretty old in India. Nagarjuna, approximately 1800-900 years ago, he has a magic square. Varahamihira's Brihat Samhita also has. A very detailed exposition is in Narayana Pandita's Ganita Kaumudi. Last chapter itself is completely dedicated to it. And there are different kinds of magic squares. Ordinary ones, semi-magic square, normal ones, span diagonal, etc. So you just do rows and columns total, they are same. That is normal or semi. Normal is the diagonals, leading diagonals also add up to the same value. But if there are other diagonals that also add up to that, other diagonals, I'll show you what they are. Then it is called a pan-diagonal magic square. This was definitely considered an art, and it is also named as Bhadra, if you notice the name. Bhadram means something auspicious, Mangalam. So it is also used in many yantras, as some of you may be aware. Next one, please. This is a pan-diagonal. Many of these are listed in Ganita Kaumudi. I just listed two of them. Here, this all total to 34, that is okay. But then you start here, say 1, and go here. What is there? There is nothing. So you come here. So this is another diagonal. So 1 plus 10 plus 16 plus 7 will also give the sum. then 14 plus 8 and then 3 plus 9 will also give the sum, and in other directions also. And here these four are also considered adjacent because it's kind of rolled. That is how you look at it. And there is one given as for some 100 also. In fact, this work exactly tells you how to place it. So one you place, then a horse move you place two. Similarly, a horse move you place three, because if you go from one above and then right, it comes to here only. Then with respect to two and three, the same place but horse move, you have to put four. Like this throughout till 16, there is a detailed procedure very beautifully specified in Samskrita shlokas. Here also you can find the patterns, and usually this is accomplished using set sequence of arithmetic series. Next one, please. And this is even more interesting, Ashtadalam Chatush Padmam. So you can consider this one quarter as a Padmam with eight petals. Like that there are four. And you total this, it will be same. You total this, it will be same. You total the middle also, it will be the same. And then you total this, 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 it will be same. So there are many properties and how to construct these. Next one, please. Recently, I came to know in Andhra, there is a Ganitavadhanam, similar to Ashtavadhanam, that is being done in schools, colleges, etc., where there are eight Prichakas. One of them is obviously an Aprastuta Prasangi, he will keep interrupting. But the other ones, one person asks fifth root of some eight-digit number, nine-digit number, and randomly a person will say 2002, August 2nd, what is the date? What is the day? So there are eight such prichakas. They'll keep asking questions and more complex. So Ganita Avadhanam is something I think people are trying to reconstruct. But as a Avadhanam, it becomes a kala also, because there are spectators who see this. Next one, please. I think I'm coming to the end of it. Yeah. So Vyavahara Ganitam, it is both practical, or sometimes from that you develop some of these interesting problems. So estimating volume of a pit. So there is a random pit, you select 3-4 places, measure the depth and the width, and then do a weighted measure where you get the volume. And then heaps of grains. So you can see in granaries there are grains heaped up. How do you estimate the volume of it? And also based on whether the grain is very small or big, there are estimates given in Leelavati. There is one text in Tamil called Kanakadikaram. I thought it will be very interesting to put it. I won't read it out, but what it says is, how many sholai is smaller ones inside the jackfruit. How many of them are there? Without cutting, you should estimate. Is there a way to estimate? They have tried to estimate. I don't know how correct it is. I tried once when I was 12 or 15 years old. I couldn't match that. But he says, you have that kamb, whatever the thing that is on the top. Around that you have sharp ones. The whole thing is only sharp. You count them and multiply by 6, divide by 5. That will give you the number of sholais inside the whole fruit, even without opening. This is there in Kanakadikaram. I think it is some kind of fun activity for people. And then there is one more next to it where in Pushanikai, Kushmanda, how many seeds are there? Some estimate he has given in the same work. I won't go into details, but mandalas, kolam, and all of this other thing also have a mathematical spatial function to it. So those can be considered as a kala by itself, part of Ganitam in a way. Next one, please. This is the last one. So Chitrakavyam that we heard in the morning, he talked about there are constraints with which you compose. Here, there is Jyotisham Ganitam by which you get a table. Table of what? Table of anything. Say, for example, there is a movement of moon, and there are 248 positions of moon which you want to memorize for easy calculation. Vakya Panchangam you might have heard. So there are 248 Vakyas. And you have got the number, some 1150453, some number with which you do some calculation. But how do you remember these numbers? You construct Vakyams in Sanskritam. Sanskritam was used before. But you have to have something which has a semblance of meaning. So they try to do that also. Shreshtam nama varishthanam. That gives one number of sign table of Madhava. You can see that some of these words are very interesting. Moolam vishuddham nalasya, ganeshu virala naraha, etc. And then there are other planetary vakyas also. Alasa naryaha kuchadhyaha. I think, so ladies are lazy, but they are big-breasted, something like that. So, jnana netraha prajnyaha. So this was also a kala in the sense you try to come up with a vakyam which is also very interesting, but at the same time you combine your knowledge of mathematics and katapayadi sankhya to come up with these. Okay, next one. I think that's it. Okay, thank you. So I just explained some of these aspects. There is a lot more, but in the given time I tried to represent what kinds of activities people were doing, which were both informative and also entertaining. Thank you.
Now we have Dr. R. H. Kulkarni ji to share his knowledge on painting. This is one art that most of us will be sort of at least acquainted with the art form. If not, we all pursue it. Dr. Raghavendra Rao H. Kulkarni is an art historian, educator and art writer. He completed a master's degree from Faculty of Fine Arts, MS University, Baroda in 1992. Further, he obtained diploma in epigraphy in 1996 and a PhD from Mysore University in 2001. He has extensively worked on Karnataka art, architecture and sculpture and authored several books and research papers on the same. Presently, Dr. Kulkarni ji is working as professor, HOD, Department of History and Art, Karnataka Chitrakala Parishat, Bengaluru. May I now request Dr. R. H. Kulkarni ji to kindly present his views.
Karnataka Udaya, ಕನ್ನಡದ ಉದಯ ತೀರಾ ಪ್ರಾಚೀನವಾದದ್ದು. ಬಹುಶಃ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಕನ್ನಡ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಆರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ನಂತರ ನಮ್ಮದಲ್ಲದ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ, ಪರಮಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ, ವ್ಯಾಸಾಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುರೂಪಾಯ, ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ವಾಸುದೇವಾಯ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ಚಿತ್ರಕಲೆ 64 ಕಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಪಿಸಿದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕಲೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್. ಸಿ, ವೆನ್ ಐ ಗಾನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್. ದಿ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ನೋನ್ ಟು ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಜುವಲ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್. ಎವ್ರಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್. ಸಿ, when we imitate our parents, when we draw with stick drawings and we create images on our notebooks, slates, anyone on our walls, you can see many of the walls are being covered with pencil drawings, paper drawing, paper cuttings, etc. These are all visual representations that are instinct by defect in every human being. So then where do we stand then? I mean, where exactly, why exactly Vatsayana and other the great scholars have listed Chitrakala as one of the art? So whatever, you know, whatever the descriptions, the details we come across in all these treatises, they represent the matured face of the Indian art, the most matured. Proudha was the proud sampradayavanna roopisuvanta ondu sandarbhavanna ee ella kritigalu maartave. Andre, there must have been a period which has taken place maybe some few thousand years ago. Same thing I would like to, since there are many historians also, without boring you, I would just give you some glimpses of the visual art, how it has taken place. Being an art historian, if I don't give you a chronicle view of the chronological view of the Indian art in general, I think I may be making mistake. So the visual art can be drishyakale, chitrakale, chitrakara, rupakara. These are the words which we use in our discipline. So there is no art without drawing. There is no art without image. See, chitrakavya, drishyakavya, even natakadallo kuda ondu drishyakalpaneyanna, parikalpaneyanna koduvantaddu. These are all manovyapara and hrudaya samvada between the artist and the art beholder or art lover. So see, the mental state. I mean, of course, when we go through into more intricacies of the Indian philosophy, from historically also we are somewhere. I think even dating of these many texts also needs a proper ratification. So many European scholars believe that Bharata was in 3rd century BC or CE, and Vatsyayana was somewhere in 5th century CE. Not exactly. That is the right way to think. When we look at the development of Indian art, so the earliest paintings, classical paintings, are to be seen in Ajanta cave number 9 and 10. These are the two caves. These are the earliest recorded historical evidences of the Indian visual art. Then what were the treatises? What was the grammar framework given to the artist of those days? So there comes the treatises that have already been known to the academia, are the known to the teachers, the artist, Rupakara. See, the India also has a very big tradition of the artist. It is not a specialization as we have today. In visual art, we have 7 disciplines: painting, sculpture, applied art, animation, graphic art, history of art, like that. But basically, in ancient period, the Shilpakara and Chitrakara were the same. They were commonly known as the Rupakara. We also use another terminology, Chitra Shilpa. The Shilpa is a dimensional, three-dimensional, whereas Chitra is an illusionary dimensional. So, keeping in mind these things, can we go to the third slide directly? Karthik, please. Just go to the second one. Yeah. See, I have jotted down the very Chitra Shadangaka. This is the framework for any work of art, any drawing or painting that is being painted and demonstrated. Rupa Bheda Pramanani Bhava Lavanya Yojanam Sadrishyam Varnika Bhangam Idam Chitra Shadangakam. With these six limbs, one can delineate, one can paint, or one can design a work of art. Any painting painted on a surface. Can we go to the fourth slide now? Go to the next, please. Yeah. Yeah. Even you can jump to the next also. I don't want to spend more time. So, besides Kama Sutra, the earliest treatise is like Chitra Sutra of Vishnu Dharmottara. That is one of the very important work which describes about the technique and also the pictorial aspect of a drawing and painting. Technique is color, the skill. So the how to make the color, how to prepare the brush, and how to prepare the ground, how to prepare the surface. That is one aspect. Second aspect is how to draw, what to draw, iconography of the figure, and if it is a female figure, what type of the female figure to be drawn. If it is a male figure, what type of the male figures to be drawn. And similarly, and color also play a symbolic, significant role in the narrating the subject. So, can we go to the next? Okay. So, the broadly, the Indian art or the tradition of the Chitrakala can be divided like a mural tradition, which of course speaks about the tradition of the development of the mural tradition in India in general, where we are more concerned with the pictorial development of the object, the imagery on the surface. So from prehistoric to even current situation, where mural tradition is being practiced, and up to including Vijayanagara and even present period also, then we have manuscript tradition, where paintings are being painted on the manuscript. See, artists who were well versed to paint the larger area now have been reduced. They have accommodated themselves to paint only a postcard size area, which is a miniature risk. It's not miniature, miniature risk. So that is the beauty of artist's flexibility to accommodate himself and also adjust according to the availability of the space. And the manuscript, paper manuscript, book illustration, etc. Then we also have the miniature tradition. We can also put them in the category of the book illustrations. So all the stories connected with Bhagavata and Puranas, etc., that have been narrated, during the Rajasthani and Pahadi traditions. Similarly, Mughal and Dakkani sultans also are important, because we also, you know, India is also known for the multicultural and also you can say cultural impact and religious impact. All we have been experiencing it and experiencing currently also. So the finally, even contemporary period also, during the, especially during the independence period, once again there was a cry for going back to the tradition. So in the beginning of the 20th century, there was a big change in the approach towards the painting, visual art. So everything was modernized, modernism, you can call it. In the name of modernism, visual art has crossed all the, you can say the grammar, and there is no grammar at all sometimes in the modernism. And also, of course, there are many theoreticians, there are many scholars, philosophers, they have jotted down every picture, how to read, how to appreciate, and also how to understand. So I am not getting into those intricacies and those issues, because I would like to show you some of the very interesting pictures that will take you through some of the, the development. Okay. Is it working? Is it? Hello? Am I audible? Yeah. Okay. See, my point is that I want you to go through the development of the Indian painting, which are the earliest human visual representations. Earliest human visual representations, you can call them as the drishya bhashe, the pictographic images that have been found on the caves and galleries of the Bhimbetka. Even in Karnataka also we have plenty of such examples. So the first two pictures represent the earliest representations. You can call them as a schematic representation. The Chitra Alekhya doesn't describe all these things. Alekhya only tell how to draw, how to paint, and what is the importance of the drawing and painting. But whereas the development can be understood in a socio-cultural milieu of the particular period. And who were the artists? The first question comes. Who were the artists of the prehistoric period? Whether they were able to imitate, understand the animal form, human form. And the same can be seen during Indus Valley. In the morning, I suppose, I noticed the pot making was done. So pottery is the representation of the cultural development in India and elsewhere, everywhere. So the pot, the burnt pot, sun-baked pot, etc., when we decorate it, we develop it, those three pots come from Indus civilization. They were found in Harappa culture. You can see by the time around 4000 BCE, if an artist was able to understand the cockfight or the flying posture of the birds, and also a Pegasus, a mythical flying horse, as it is being mentioned in our Puranas, Gandharva Kudre Melinda, Swargadinda Banda, Alinda Banda, Antana Kategalan Nella Kirateve. So Hagadre, E Samskruti Yaudu, Indus Samskruti, Vaidika Samskruti Agir Bahude, Agitti and Nodukuda Sakas to Pradnaru Churcha Martidare. Andre, Sanudesha Este, one the Akrati, one the Belibe Kadre, Andina Samaja, Andina Samskruti, other male, Prabhava Kari Agirtade. So Indus civilization clearly represent how the art, visual art forms were appearing on their pottery. Unfortunately, we don't have any painting on the Indus Valley houses, because they have been destroyed or demolished in the time span. But the whatever pottery that have been discovered, thanks to R.D. Banerjee and M.S. Watts, Sir John Marshall, to remember the name, those are the people who unearthed these potteries. So now, let me take you through Buddhist art. See, earliest classical art in India is a Buddhist art only. We have to agree to it. There's no any discrimination, or there's no any sort of a discussion, any sort of additional discussion. We have to accept it as a fact, because Ajanta is the earliest place where we come across the early classical historical paintings. Historical paintings, they are attested by the epigraphs, inscriptions. Cave number 9 and 10 have an inscription referring to the Shatavahana kings. Shatavahana, the paligraphy, the style of the writing is also again part of the Rupakara, artist again. So the painting what you see is a Mahajanaka Jataka, one of the very important Jataka stories. Look at the illusion created by the artist. So as if Mahajanaka, the king Mahajanaka, who is converting to Buddhist faith, he was given ordinance by Buddha himself. So that is the story. He was a close relative of the Buddha again. So the interesting thing is how architecture is represented. And we even today we have similar architecture being present in many villages. Even all rural houses have the open veranda. With now helate Uttara Karnataka dalli bankad mane anta helate na andre bankad mane andre it is a open veranda house. Cave temples have a open veranda cave temples only. That is how the architecture also continues. Please tell me, sir, university teachers are always governed by 1 hour talk. If I continue, please stop me in between. So I will wind up. 5 minutes? Okay. Go to the next, quickly. Yeah. So Vidura Pandita Jataka again from the, Now there is something I would like to tell you, how sculptor and painters are one. That is one of the best example to illustrate. This is a Maravijaya panel, Maravijaya. One of the very important episodes of the Buddha's life. Maravijaya panel in painting as well as in sculpture. You can see identical form, identical outlines, except color, that is a flat two-dimensional and it's a three-dimensional. So that's what I was clearly mentioning. Chitrakara, Chitrashilpi, Rupakara all stand for the same. There's no any differentiation between painter and sculptor. Okay. Yeah, Badami. Yeah, you can go quickly, you can run quickly. Yeah, there are many pictures which I have used from different parts and different times frame. Maybe we can go to Vijayanagara and then I wind up my talk. Yeah, this is the Prajnaparamita, the manuscript paintings. And yeah, go to the next, please. Yeah. This is one of the very important painting of Girija Kalyana in Hampi, Virupaksha temple. So Girija Kalyana is a very popular painting, popular theme even in the Mysore traditional painting. Even in Mysore traditional painting and Kamada, the Maravijaya and again Manmatha Vijaya, Tripura Samhara. And of course, these are the traditional Mysore painting. So the painting which has been seen from Bimbetka, that is earliest period, to Kochi Binale. Kochi Binale is the most modernist happening in Kerala, that is the most modernist happening in Kerala, the painting has developed as an independent stream. The visual art has developed as an independent stream. But one thing, there is no strong guru parampara in painting and drawing, the way the music and other arts have. It is, artist as a self, many a times artist as a self-taught, even if they are going to academia, etc., they develop their own style. But whereas in music, you follow the tradition. So here the artist enjoyed maximum freedom of their expression and impression. Thank you very much.
May I now request Sri Venkata Subramanian ji to kindly sum up the session.
Guru reva gatihi guru meva bhaje, guru naiva sahasmi namo gurave, na guroh paramam sishurasmi guroh, matirasti gurau mama pahi guru, hayagriva hayagriva hayagriveti yovadet, tasya nissarate vani janhukanya pravahavat, Vasudeva Sutandevam Kamsachanura Mardanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum. We have all been witnessing this Chatushashti Kala program. The moment Alvar Mahodaya called me and said, Chatushashti Kala, we are doing a seminar. the first thing I was thinking, what is the significance of this word chatushashti? Chatushashti pacharadhya. Lalita Sahasranama has, Sri Vidya Upasana has got chatushashti upachara puja. Adi Shankara has given Devi chatushashti upachara stotram. The Phalashruti is, we can become kavis like Dr. Shankar if we tell that shloka daily. In Vyakarana, being a Vyakarana scholar or Vyakarana student, sorry, Chatushashti Varnaha Shambhumate Mataha Shiksha Shastreshu Uktam Tatrapi Chatushashtihi Prayaha Varnitaha. In Ganapati Sahasranama, Chatushashtyarna Nirneta Chatushashti Kala Nidhihi Iti Tatra Ganapati Ganesha Sahasranamni Vartate. So this Chatushashti is, though there are 86 Kalas as told by Professor M.D. Srinivas and our Anand Mahodaya, still this Chatushashti has got lot of significance. And the other point I was dwelling was, what is the difference between Vidyasthana and Kala, which all the points have been captured between Professor M.D. Srinivas and Dr. H.V. Nagaraj Rao. But one thing which I was contemplating on, the Vidyasthanas, sometimes you require the Anubandha Chatushtaya for the Vidyasthanas, whereas for Kala, it is more more inclusive and more diversified. The Kalas give an opportunity for everyone to participate and experience the Paratattva. So I think that was the purpose of this conference. Spiritually, we experience the Paramatma, and I think that was the purpose of this Kalas. And Mooka Loka Sulabha. Even for a Mooka who cannot speak, most of these Kalas can be practiced. So this was a very important point, I thought. Sarva Grahya, Sarva Manya, Sarvanubhavya. That is, everybody can experience it. In our Shastras, these Kalas were used as a tool or something to enhance our bhakti, for experiencing, expressing, enhancing the bhaktis. These Kalas have proved as enablers. For example, when we do an Alankara, Pushpalankara, it is also a Kala, I think, in the list. When we do, they say Pushpa Shaya, when we do the, create a Shaya of flowers, that is also a Kala. Now, Shaya of flowers can be created for a different purpose. It can also be created for a Dolotsava in Nama Sankirtana. So, finally, these Kalas are best enablers of bhakti. There were four topics today we had. Gemology, mathematics, vastu, angavidya, shakuna shastram, shubha nimittam, visual arts, painting. In that we had so many things. I was thinking, what is the best text to experience all these subjects in one text? Can we experience? So the best text I found was Ramayana, Sri Valmiki Ramayana. Let us start with the gemology. Grihitva prekshamanasa bhartuh karavibhushanam bhartaravima samprapta janaki mudita bhavat. So we know that Mani Mantram Aushadam, our speaker said. So Mani was given, which was the Anguliyaka. That Anguliyaka was given by Janaka, and it was prepared, Yagyavalkya has given it to Janaka. It was prepared in a special way. The moment somebody receives that Anguliyaka, the person whom they have in mind, Smarana, that is seen, and that is why Bhartaram Iva Samprapta. So Mani, Mantram, Aushadam. Mantra was all the Shastragyas, they say, Ashtakshari Mahamantra was given as Upadesha by Hanuman to Sita, and therefore Jivatma Paramatma Sammelanam happened. through that incident. So Mani Mantram Aushadam, and our Kulashekhar Alwar has given this concept, Bhaktapaya Bhujanga Garuda Manihi Trailokya Raksha Manihi Gopi Lochana Chatakambuda Manihi Saundarya Mudra Manihi Shatruchedaika Mantram Sakalam Upanishad Vakya Sampujya Mantram. I am just skipping Jihve Shri Krishna Mantram. This is a Krishna's place. Japa Japa Satatam Janma Saphalya Mantram Vyamoha Prasamaushadham Munimano Evam Shri Krishna Divyaushadam Piba Iti Tatra Samaptihi Bhavishyati. Evam, so this Mani Mantra Aushadham has been dealt with in Ramayana in a very detailed way. If we come to the Shakuna Shastra and the Anga Shastra and the Nimitta, we know in Ramayana Sundarakanda we have the Trijata Swapna Varnanam. I used to tell my grandfather, I did not sleep well. What happened? Some Duswapna came. The first thing he used to say is, Ramayana has got all Pariharas. Please read Trijata Swapnam and go for your school. We used to read Trijata Swapnam. What is there in that Trijata Swapnam? If you see, Gajadanta Mayim Divyam Shibikam Antarikshagam Yuktam Hamsa Sahasrena Swayam Asthaya Raghavaha Shuklamalyam Bharadaraha Lakshmanena Sahagataha Ramanena Sangata Sita Bhaskarena Prabhayata. This was the Swapna seen by Trijata with respect to Rama, Lakshmana and Sita. With respect to Ravana, Durgandham Dussaham Ghoram Timiram Narakopamam Malapankam Pravishyashu Magnastatras Saravanaha. So then we have the next sarga, Tathagatam Tam Vyatitam Anindhitam Vyapeta Harsham Paridina Manasam. That sarga is all the Shubha Nimittani. Our scholar has already told the difference between Nimitta and Shakuna. Samudrika Lakshanas, the Angavidya. Ramayana is the best place. Yani Raman Ramasya Chinhani Lakshmanasya Chavanara Tani Bhuya Samachakshva. So she is asking for the Samudrika Lakshana of Rama. Rama Kamala Patrakshaha Sarvasattva Manoharaha Rupa Dakshinya Sampannaha Prasuto Janakatmaje Trivalivastrivanataha Chaturvyangas Trishirshavan Chatushkala Chaturlekas Chatushkishkus Chatussamaha. Suppose you had a tailor and you explain the meaning of these shlokas, he will stitch a nice clothes for our Rama. That is the kind of description which is given in Ramayana. Very beautifully the Samudrika Lakshanas have been explained. A lot of shlokas in Sundarakanda, in Ayodhya Kanda about this. Next, when we come to Vastu, in Ayodhya Kanda, I think Sarga 56, we have this Parnashala. So not only for a mud hut, our scholar was telling about mud hut also requires Vastu. Ramayana says, the Parnashala which was created by Lakshmana, he says, Vastu karma niveshancha Bharata Gamanantatha. So Rama prepares himself and says to Lakshmana that we have to do the Vastu Karma and then enter this Parnashala. And he takes bath, and he, because they are Kshatriyas, they give some balis. Based on that, the shlokas go in that 56th Adhyaya, Sarga. So the Vastu is also there. Lot of areas Vastu has been described. Regarding this Chitrakala painting, in Ramayana, the shlokas are like this. Lata grihani chitrani, chitrashala grihani cha. So the galleries, chitrashala grihani cha, the galleries of paintings were there in Lankapuri. There is one more shloka in Sundarakanda. Satasya madhye bhavanasya marutihi, lata grihan, chitragrihan, nishagrihan, lata grihan, chitragrihan, nishagrihan. You see, there also chitragrihan is coming. The pictures, the galleries, art galleries, these were there. So like this, Ramayana is a place, Adikavya is a place where you can see all these aspects, mathematics. So our Anand Vishwanathan will be very worried. Our chairperson did not touch mathematics in Ramayana. Mathematics, the number of vanras, I think he knows about it. The 10 to the power, 69 or 64, sir? 64. So much of vanaras. So each vanara king comes and he comes to Sugriva. And in one sarga, this Ravana Dutas, they describe how many monkeys were there. There was an article in Sambhasha Sandesh also about this number of varanas and the powers, etc. So, and you, in the Ramayana Mahatmya Shlokas, Raghavo Vijayam Dadyat Mama Sita Vatif Prabhu. If you want to do the Parayana of Sundarakanda in 15 days or 30 days in two rotations, you apply the Katavaya Sankhya to Raghavo Vijayam Dadyat, Ra 2, 5, like that first day, two sargas, second day as per that Raghavo Vijayam Dadyat. Tatra Raghavasya Padadvandvam Dadyam Amita Vaibhavam. Tarihi Amita Vaibhavam Vayam Prapnuvaha Yetadrisha Parayana Kramena Iti Tatra Ullikitaha Vartate. So, finally, important questions that I thought, I will just summarize in 2 minutes. Important questions I thought this conference is dealing with. How we all can provide answers to this? See, this entire this Chatushashti Kala is actually being documented by Sanskriti Foundation in the form of a book. There are a lot of individual experts who have written books on each of the kalas. As a summary book, it is being concised. So, I am sure if it is coming from Sanskriti Foundation, it is very authentic. Already, Sanskriti Foundation is working in this area. So, first thing is we should have authentic data, information, I think from all the experts. There should be no dilution. Even minor exaggeration leads to discounting the entire Indian knowledge system. This is what we should be careful about. The next point, that these are 5 points which I want to tell. The next point is how to store this data or information for the next generation, which is what our minister was telling. And how to prevent a Nalanda occurring once again. Nalanda Daha occurring once again. So how to capture the tacit knowledge present in the mind of Dr. M.D. Srinivas, Dr. H.V. Nagaraj Rao. How to capture this knowledge? What amount of knowledge was presented by Dr. Shankar? The way we have to do this. And the amount of knowledge presented by Anandji, our Kulkarni ji, and our Vastu Vidya expert, all of these people, how to capture this tacit knowledge in a place and how to give it for next generation? Will next generation read so many books? If you keep on putting volume of books, will they read? So the solution is technology is the answer. We have to have store this in through technology, through videos, through different kinds of courses. We should actually have courses. And that is the direction which Vyoma Linguistic Labs is working. And this was the direction given to us by Professor Lakshmi Tatachar. And even today, Alvar sir, I have great regards for Professor Alvar and Professor Lakshmi Tatachar. Because when I first met Lakshmi Tatachar, he gave me exactly 320 ideas. He said, which area you want to work? That was a meeting of 4 hours in which he gave me 320 ideas. I have made a list. So then he said, which is the idea you want to work on? I said, e-learning, virtual learning. Then he said, please proceed, that's a very good area. So it was Professor Lakshmi Tatachar, who is the founder of this Sanskriti Foundation, who initiated us to work in this area. And we are storing this in the form of courses. I would encourage all scholars who are this one, if you want to do individual courses on these Chaturdasha Kalas, please use Vyoma and please present this. The next point is how to make this open and accessible to everyone, like an app or Hastalabhya. Durlabhya Vastunyapi Hastalabhya Yatanyat in Narayanyam Dese. So we have to, even if it is durlabha, you have to give it to hastalabhya. Then only people are today accessing it. So how to make this better than the finance and the IT profession or whatever profession is there? See, there were days when somebody will ask, you are practicing dance, you are practicing painting. Okay, what do you do for your living? Which degree are you pursuing? They don't realize that music, art, dance, etc. can also be a passion and a life itself. We have seen Jambavans in the area of musics and in the area of Shastra and in the area of Kalas. So this tradition of each of these Kalas becoming a field of its own where we can have a living and we can have a career or whatever it is also should be constantly told. And last point is how to have this more institutions for this 64 Kalas. See, Alvar Mohodaya was suggesting this kind of Kalas. You tell me a school which is practicing or which gives importance to these Kalas. I openly told about Purnapramati. We have a founder of Purnapramati, founder Srinivas present here. So I see that the teachers of Purnapramati are here. The founder himself is here. They give utmost respect to these Kalas and they teach these Kalas. Now you see here you have an organization, Samskriti Foundation, who is building authentic documentation for people to use. And then you have organizations like Purnapramati who can use this information and organizations like Vyoma who can use this information and disseminate it to the world. So that Prachara Karya, which is four parts, I think, which we Dr. Nagaraj Rao said, you cannot, Bodha also should happen, Prachara also should happen. So that Prachara Karya should come. The total number of, if you go to the mainstream education and talk about these Kalas, which Kala are we doing? They will put it in one bracket as vocational or something and they'll say, no, this is the main things are, these things are the mainstreams. So we have to bring this to the mainstream education. Some of the Kalas are already coming in schools like Purnapramati. It is already being fully done. I have seen a full demonstration of all the Kalas being done in front of Swamiji in Udupi by Purnapramati staff and Purnapramati's children. Every Kala, including Kalaripayattu, is being given importance there. So we have to identify such institutions and connect them so that the pathways or this conference does not remain as a mere conference where we came and had nice food in ISKCON. That what we remember out of this is nice food and nice people. We should also remember the subject and we should carry forward this subject further. I think all of us have come with that mind. We will take this forward. And I thank Professor Lakshmi Tatachar who guided us initially and Professor Alvar who has given me this opportunity. And regarding the summary of these papers, these people are stalwarts in their own fields. I am just a small person doing some prachara karya. I will not be able to summarize their papers, nor would I be able to speak or comment on what they have said. But I have used this opportunity to share my ideas. Thank you very much. Thank you all the speakers for keeping up your time. Thank you.